What I know comes off an FBI report. Don't ask me how. How you can figure out. I've been around long enough. The kid gets, I don't think he was murdered. I think, I don't think he was murdered because of what he knew. The kid's a nice boy, 27. He was not an IT expert, but he learned stuff. He was a data programmer, but he learned stuff. And so he's living on one street somewhere. He's living on one street. He's living in a very rough neighborhood. And in the exact area was where he'd been, there have been about 10, I'm sure you know all this, there have been about 8 or 9 or 10 violent robberies, most of them with somebody brandishing a gun. And it's the kid's hand, I'm telling you, I'm sure you know it, his hands were marked up. The cops concluded he fought off the people, tried to run, and they shot him twice in the back with a .22, small caliber. And then the kids that did it ran. They got scared, didn't take his wallet. Okay, so what the cops do then, and here's what nobody knows, what I'm telling you. Now, maybe you know something about it. When you have a death like that, D.C. cops, if you're dead, you generally don't just go, you have to find out what's going on. You have to get to the kid's apartment and see what you can find. If he's dead, you don't need a warrant, but most cops get a warrant because they don't know if the guy has a roommate. You need a warrant. So they get a warrant. I'm just telling you, there is such a thing. They go in the house and they can't do much with his computer, his password. The cops don't know much about it. So the D.C. cops, they have a cyber unit in D.C., and they're more sophisticated. They come and look at it. The idea is maybe he's had a series of exchanges with somebody who says, I'm going to kill you, motherfucker, over a girl, or... And they can't get in. The cyber guys do a little better, but they can't make sense of it. So they call the FBI cyber unit. The DC unit, the Washington field office, is a hot shit unit. The guy running the Washington field office, he's like a 3-star at an army base. He's ready looking for 4. You know what I mean? He's going to go with a top job. There's a cyber unit there that's excellent. Yeah. What you get in a warrant, the public information you get in a warrant doesn't include, it does not include the affidavit underlying why you're going in, what the reasons are. That's almost never available on. I can tell you that. The existence of a warrant is a public document 99% of the time. So they, and the same warrant, they call in the Fed. The Feds get through, and here's what they find. This is according to the FBI report. What they find is he makes, first of all, you have to know some basic facts. One of the basic facts is there's no DNC or Podesta email that exists beyond May 22nd, May 21st, 22nd. The last email for either one of those groups. And so what the report says that sometime in late spring, we're talking about June, you know, summer's in June 21st. Late spring would be after, I presume, I don't know. I just say it says late spring, early summer. He makes contact with WikiLeaks. That's in his computer, and he makes contact. Now, I have to be careful because I met Julian in Europe, Julian, 10, 12 years. I stay the fuck away from people like that. You know, he's invited me, and when I'm in London, I always get a message, come see me at the Ecuadorian ambassador, and there's no fucking way I'm going there. I've got enough trouble without getting photographed by every fucking age. He's under total surveillance by everybody. But anyway, they found what he had done. He had submitted a series of documents, of emails, some juicy emails from the DNC. And, you know, by the way, all this shit about the DNC, you know, whether hacked or wasn't hacked, but whatever happened, the Democrats themselves wrote this shit. You know what I mean? All I know is that he offered a sample, an extensive sample, you know, I'm sure dozens of emails, and said, I want money. That later, WikiLeaks did get the password. He had a Dropbox, a protected Dropbox, which isn't hard to do. I mean, you don't have to be a wizard, IT wizard. You know, he was certainly, you know, he's not a dumb kid. They got access to the Dropbox. He also, and this is also in the FBI report, he also let people know with whom he was dealing. And I don't know how he dealt, I'll tell you about WikiLeaks in a second. I don't know how he dealt with the WikiLeaks and the mechanism, but he also, the word was passed according to the FBI report. I also shared this box with a couple of friends. So if anything happens to me, it's not going to solve your problem. Okay? I don't know what that means. I don't know whether he was, anyway, but WikiLeaks got access, and before he was killed, I can tell you right now, Brennan's an asshole. I've known all these people for years. Clapper's sort of a better guy, but not rocket scientist. The NSA guy is a fucking moron. And they all, you know, the trouble with all those guys is that the only way they're going to make it to a board or two and get, you know, hired by SAIC to deliver some fat cat contracts is if Hillary stayed in. With Trump, they're gone. You know, they're done. They're going to live on their pension. They're not going to make it. And I got to tell you, guys in that job, they don't want to live on their pension. They want to be on boards like their president. Make $600,000 for going to four visits. I have somebody on the inside. You know, I've been around a long time and I write a lot of stuff. I have somebody inside who will go and read a file for me. This person is unbelievably accurate and careful. He's a very high-level guy. He'll do a favor. You're just going to have to trust me. I have what they call in my business long-form journalism. I have a narrative of how that whole fucking thing began. It's a Brennan operation. It was an American disinformation. And fucking the fucking president, at one point when they even started telling the press, they were back briefing the press. The head of the NSA was going and telling the press, this fucking cocksucker Rogers, was telling the press that we even know who in the GRU, the Russian military intelligence service, leaked it. I mean, all bullshit. They were telling these two. I worked at the New York Times for fucking years, and the trouble with the fucking New York Times is they have smart guys, but they're totally beholden on sources. If the president or the head of the CIA tells them something, they actually believe it. I was hired at the Times to write about it, to go after the war, in the Vietnam War in 72, because they were just locked in. So that's what the Times is. These guys run the fucking Times. And Trump's not wrong. I mean, I wish he would calm down and had a better press secretary. Trump's not wrong to think they all fucking lied about him. I can tell you right